my first international trip out of the U.S. Very excited for this park. You can see Leviathan, you have Wonder Mountains Guardian, you have Behemoth, you have these amazing coasters here that I'm very excited to ride. We're going to try to get all the coasters in today, try to get all the main coasters. Probably won't get on some of the kiddie coasters because of the time limit we have. I'm trying to get on all of them. But today looks like a really fun day. It's really packed here, so that's kind of a bummer. I kind of figured it would be, but this is actually a lot more than I expected. But so far, it looks like a fun day today. It looks like a great park, very beautiful, and so far, it looks like an awesome day today.
Thank you.
anyone gone to King's Dominion before, you know Grizzly. It's very, it's like basically the same ride. It's very rough, not very fun. It's average. It is a little rough of a ride. Yet again, it's just like Grizzly. So I wouldn't recommend riding this if there's a long line. But if it's a walk, I'd definitely get on this ride for the credit. I don't think I'll ever ride this again unless I'm here and it's a short ride. But it's okay.
Thank you.
Vekoma SLC, and that was easily one of my least favorite coasters ever. So bumpy, the restraints are awful, you're hitting your ears against the restraints every 5 seconds, and it feels like through some of the inversions it's literally breaking, and then you slam your head against the restraints, and it's just awful. It's one of the worst roller coasters I've ever ridden, and it probably stayed that way. It was so bad, it was so uncomfortable, and so just unbearable. I will never step foot on this coaster again. What did you think about this awful coaster?
I liked it because there was like no bottom, it's kind of like on the ice, and you ran a loop. So when you ran a loop, like you didn't really know because like you couldn't see the track because it's above you, and you're like, and that was interesting.
So I think we're gonna go ride some other coasters. Yet again, awful coaster. He likes that. I think it's. And I can understand why people before this said that SLCs weren't good, and I thought maybe I'd give it a shot, but that was really, really bad. And I agree with people that think this is bad. Time Warp here at Canada's Wonderland. It is a very awkward, weird coaster. It's fun. It's enjoyable. A little advice would be to put your hand on the side of your head because the ride is kind of rickety and rough, so that kind of protects your ears there. But it's really fun. If they had better restraints, I think it would be definitely a better ride. It's fun. It's average. I'd give it 5.5 maybe out of 10. So that's it for now. I'll see you guys later. We just have a backbot stunt coaster, the multi-launch coaster here, located at Canada's Wonderland. And that was really, really fun. Exact replica of the ones at King's Dominion and King's Island. I actually felt shorter and not as good as the one at King's Dominion. It's probably pretty true, because instead of holding you at the grip run up at the top, it shoots you off as soon as you get up there. It's fun, it's average, nothing too great. I ride it 4.5, 5.5 maybe. It's average, it's fun, it's okay. So now we're going to go check out the other coasters, and then we're going to re-ride everything else. So I'll see you guys later.
Thank you.
I just rode the slingshot here at Canada's Wonderland, and it was fun. It wasn't as intense and as fast as I thought it would be. I like the Sky Flyers better than this ride. It's really fun still. It's fast, and once you get that first let go of the magnetic brakes, it's not. And once you go up to the top, it's not really that fun anymore. You just gotta go down and up. Extreme Sky Flyer, even though you're not dropping anymore, you're still going high and up, and it's still really fun. I didn't find this one as fun as Extreme Sky Flyer, but it was still fun. What did you think of this ride?
It wasn't as intense as I thought, but it was still really fun. Like, when you got to the top, you could see, like, everything.
So we're going to go check out the other roller coasters here at Canada's Wonderland, and we'll see you guys later. Fun. It feels like a lot faster than it's actually going. It feels like you're zooming down here off this lift hill right here. And it is so intense, it's so fun, so thrilling, it's so exciting. It's just a great coaster. One of my favorite aero coasters ever. It's really smooth. There's no headbanging at all, and I was shocked by that. I kept tensing up thinking, oh, here comes the aero headbanging. But no. And it was just a really, really great ride, and I really enjoyed it. Carolina, the Flying Cobras, the Carolines. It's pretty similar to that. I think it's a little bit not as good, but I think that's because Flying Cobra just received a new paint job and a new theme and everything. But this was fun. It was enjoyable. I wouldn't ride this again. It was an average coaster, and it was okay. Dragonfire, the aerodynamics custom looper here at Canada's Wonderland. And although some of the parts of the ride were bumpy, it was still really, really fun and really enjoyable. And it's a classic coaster, reminds me of like Loch Ness Monster. Not as rough as Anaconda, but not as smooth as I think Loch Ness Monster is. It was a good ride, it was okay, it was fun. Average coaster here again at Canada's Wonderland. Last ride on the night of Leviathan. It was very exciting. We got a quick queue here, and we're about to head on to the last ride of the night. Overall, a great park. So, when you think Girls Think Lake Cruise, I'll see you guys later when I review Canada's Wonderland.